Hello everybody and welcome to the third video in this Python OpenCV tutorial series. In this video, I'm going to be talking about cameras. Now specifically, I'm going to be showing you how we can load our webcam, how we can view that in live time, and then how we can kind of create a cool image using our webcam. So specifically, I'm going to take our webcam, I'm going to take whatever image is being shown, I'm going to duplicate it 4 times, and then I'm going to rotate those images and put them all into one image and then display that. And anyways, you'll see how it works, but this is kind of cool, pretty interesting. And yes, you will need a webcam for this tutorial, but if you do not have a webcam, you can replicate this with a video file. I will discuss that when we get to that point. Anyways, let's dive in here. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm here in my file and I'm going to import NumPy as np. Now, I don't think I discussed installing this in previous videos. That is because this is going to be installed by default when you install OpenCV. Then I'm going to import CV2. All right, so now what I want to do is actually load a webcam image or load a video capture device. So what I'm going to say is cap, standing for capture, is equal to then CV2 dot and then video capture. Now inside of here, I'm going to put 0. Now what you do in here is you put the number of the webcam or the video device specifically that you want to use. So if you had multiple cameras, 0 would access one of them, 1 would access the other, 2 would access the next one, so on and so forth. Now for most of you, you're probably only going to have one webcam, so just put 0. Now, if you don't have a webcam and you still want to follow along, that's totally fine. You can do so. Download some MP4 video or whatever .mov video. I don't think it matters the type of video you have, to be honest. And just put it in this OpenCV's tutorial folder or put it beside your script. And then what you can do here is rather than putting a 0, you can just put the file name that you want to load. So if you put the file name, then it will load that video and then the steps that I'm about to show you will work the exact same. So now that I have my video capture device defined, what I want to do is use this video capture device. So I'm going to set up a while loop. This while loop is going to go until we press a key on our keyboard to quit. And what this will do is just keep displaying the video device or the webcam itself. So it's hard to explain this, but we're just going to say while true. So loop infinitely. And then inside of here, the first thing that we're going to do is get a frame from our video capture device. So I'm going to say RET. And then frame is equal to, and then cap dot, and then read. Now, all you have to do is put read. What this is going to return, cap dot read, is the frame, which is actually the image itself. So it's going to be a NumPy array that represents our image. And then ret, now what ret is it's going to tell you if this capture actually worked properly. So sometimes when you have a video capture device, for example, right now, my webcam is being used by OBS, which is my screen recording software. So right now, this while loop is not going to be able to function, or this capture is not going to work because it's not going to be able to use my camera when another resource is using that. So in that case, return or RET here would return false, and that would tell me, hey, there's an issue. So we're not actually going to use this variable, but we just put it here because this does return two things, and well, that's what it returns. Anyways, what we want to do though is we want to display the frame. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say CV2 dot and then imshow. I'm going to say not IN, imshow. I'm going to title my window frame and then I'm going to show the frame. So this will take the frame from my video device and just display it. And then what I'm going to do is write the following. I'm going to say if CV2 dot wait key like that and then 1 equals equals and then the ordinal of Q, then we're going to break. Now what this is going to do is it's going to wait up to 1, I think this is 1 second, maybe this is 1 millisecond, actually let me check that. All right, so I just checked this, it is actually milliseconds. So what this means is that the CV2.wait key is going to wait 1 millisecond. And if it gets to 1 millisecond, we'll just move on after that. But if we press a key within that 1 millisecond, what's going to happen is this function right here, so CV2.waitKey, is going to return the ordinal value or the ASCII value associated with the key that we press. So for example, if we press Q, it's going to return some integer that's like 113 or 114 or some number like that. And then what we can do is compare that to the key that we wanted to have pressed. So if we want to say press Q to actually end our window here, to stop the frame capture from happening, then what we would do is say CV2.waitKey is equal to, and then the ordinal value of Q. Now the ordinal is just an integer, again, in ASCII that represents this value. If you don't know what ASCII is, don't worry, but it's just a table that represents all of the keys on your keyboard as single integer values. So we're going to check if the key that we press is equal to Q. If you want this to be X, you would change this to be X here. And just remember that what's happening is this is returning the integer of the key that you pressed. All right, so now that we have that, at the very end of our while loop, so if we do break out of this, I'm going to say cap.release. Now, what this is going to do is release the camera resource. So another program, say like OBS, for example, is now able to use the camera. So when I say cap equals cv2.video capture, it's going to take hold of the camera. It's going to use that resource. Then I need to release it. And then finally, I'm going to say cv2.destroy all windows. All right, so that is our basic program. I need to deactivate my webcam here because I need to make sure that my, CV2 script here can actually access the webcam. And now let me run this script. All right, so my face is up on the screen now. I think you guys can see me all right. And yeah, you can see that it is actually just showing me, it's displaying the webcam on the screen. And the way this works, right, is we're going through all of the code here, and then every single frame, so every single 1 millisecond in this case, because we're waiting 1 millisecond, it's grabbing or reading the information from the camera, and then it's displaying that on the screen. So now what I want to show you how to do is how we manipulate this so that there can be 4 of me on the screen, and then we're going to rotate all of me in different directions just so you have an idea of what it looks like, and it's kind of interesting. So to close this, you press Q on your keyboard. It's going to quit that. So let me reactivate my webcam here, and now let's code out the rest of this. So what I want to do is I want to take this frame here, and rather than just showing this frame, I want to turn this frame into 4 separate images, and I want to put all of those images together so I have kind of 4 quadrants and they're all my face. So what I need to do to do this is first create a blank kind of canvas that I can put my face into. So what I'm going to say is image is equal to, and then np dot and then zeros. Now I'll discuss what this does in 1 second. And then inside of here, I want to put the shape of the image that I want to create. So what I'm doing is creating an empty NumPy array. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to use this array as my image, and then I want to pretty much paste the image here, so the image from the frame, into this array. So np.zeros is going to fill my entire array, whatever shape I decide that it's going to be, with all zeros. So we'll make the entire image black by default. So let me show you this, but I do np.zeros, and then inside of here, I pass the shape of the array that I want to create. Now, when we're talking about shape, that's going to be the rows, the columns, and the channels. So I want this shape to be identical to the shape of my frame. So to do that, I'm just going to say frame.shape, because what you pass to np.zeros is just the shape. So we will pass the exact same shape as our frame, which is frame.shape. Then after that, you need to define the type of this array. So what type all of the values are. And in this case, I'm going to say np.uint8. Which stands for, I believe this is unsigned integer 8 bits. I believe that's what it stands for. Again, you don't have to understand that, but that's the idea. So now what I'm gonna do is rather than showing the frame, I'm gonna show this image just to show you what it looks like. So let's display this on the screen. All right, and so we can see that we have this kind of empty black frame showing up here. This is just the image that we created when we made this array. So image equals np.zeros, which means fill this entire array with zeros. And well, that's what I'm displaying. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to convert this into a canvas that has 4 of me on it. So I'm going to quit this with Q. Let's reactivate our video here. And now let's continue. Let's make this full screen. All right, so now what I'm going to do is I am going to pretty much copy myself 4 times into this image. But first, what I need to do is I need to take this frame and I need to shrink it so it is exactly half of the size that it was originally. So if I want to put myself 4 times onto that black image you just saw, that means that I need to take myself, which is represented by this frame. The frame is the image from the camera, and I need to shrink that image and then paste it 4 times. So I'm going to say smaller underscore frame is equal to, and then CV2 dot resize, and I'm going to resize my frame, and I'm going to put 0, 0 here, and I'm going to resize this such that is exactly half the size. So fx equals 0.5 and fy equals 0.5. There we go. So now we will be able to fit 4 of these images on our canvas. Now, some of you may be saying, well, you shrunk it by half. So how does that mean you're going to be able to fit 4? Shouldn't you only be able to fit 2? Well, since I shrunk both the width and the height by half, that means that I will actually be able to fit 4. So we will continue in 1 second, but I need to thank the sponsor of this video and this series, which is Algo Expert. AlgoExpert is the best platform to use when preparing for your software engineering coding interviews. Personally, it helped me land an internship at Microsoft and an internship at Shopify. I'm actually now an employee for AlgoExpert. I create algorithms questions. So if you want to check it out, then go to the link in the description and use the code TechWithTim for a discount on the platform. So now that I have this smaller frame variable defined, I have an image or I have an array that represents whatever was here from the video. And I want to paste that into my image. So this is going to involve me figuring out the width and the height of my image, because where I need to place this is dependent on, well, the width of the image and the height of the image. And when I say image, I'm talking about, sorry, the frame. So we'll take this frame, which is whatever the webcam is, and then we'll figure out the width and height of it. And then at half of the width and half of the height, we'll place one of these images. And then at all the other quadrants, we'll place an image. So to get the width and height of your video capture, what you do is the following. You can say width is equal to, and then cap dot get. And then inside of here, we're going to put 3. Now I'm going to surround this by int, and I'll discuss why in a second. But what cap dot get 3 is going to do is give you the width property of your frame or of your video capture. Sorry. So 3 is just kind of the identifier for a property. In this case, that property is width. Now it turns out that to get the height, let me just copy this. You're actually going to change the 3 to be equal to 4. Now, I actually believe that there's about 17 different properties of this capture object of your video capture, and you access them by saying cap.get and then whatever the integer is that represents that property. Now, you'd have to look up the documentation to see what all of those are, but 3 is width and 4 is height. So this is how we get the width and the height. The reason I'm converting them to integers is because by default, these come in as floating point values. And while I cannot use a floating point value in a slice, which is what I'm about to do. So I'm going to say now that my image and then a slice, and we're going to say colon up to width integer divided by 2, comma, colon up to height integer divided by 2. And sorry, this actually needs to be the other way around. So height integer divided by 2, and then width integer divided by 2. And sorry, colon before here again, is equal to, and then in this case, we're going to say the smaller frame. So what we're doing is we're taking the smaller frame and just pasting it, in this case, in the top left-hand corner of this new image that we just created. So that's why I'm doing this slice is exactly half the height and half the width. So that will be the same dimensions as my smaller frame. All right, now I'm going to copy this and let's paste it twice more, or actually let's paste it 4 times in total. So now what I need to do is just change these slices such that I'm pasting this image in every single quadrant. So now what I'm going to say is, all right, well, we've pasted it in the top left. Now let's paste it in the bottom left. So to paste it in the bottom left, I'm going to say height integer divided by 2 colon. So this means start at height divided by 2 and go to the end. And then again, we will paste it at width over 2. So on the left hand side of the image. So start at 0 and go to width integer divided by 2. Next, I'm going to leave my height this way because I'm now going to paste this image in the top right. So to paste this image in the top right, I just change my colon. So now we start at width integer divided by 2 and go to 0. And then lastly, I'm going to change my height again here. So now we're going to do the bottom right. I'm going to change my width to be that. So this is the top left. This is the bottom left. This is the, what was this? I'm trying to remember what this is now. I believe this is the top right. And then yes, this should be the bottom right. Okay, so that is where I'm pasting all these images. That is how the slices work. Now let me deactivate my webcam again and let's run this. So if all has worked here, you should ideally see 4 of me popping up in this image. So let me make sure that this is actually going to display. And there we go. You can now see 4 of me showing up here. So again, I pasted it in the correct area. Now what I want to do though is take this image and rotate them. So one of these will be rotated clockwise. The other one counterclockwise. Maybe we'll change one of them to gray. And we can do whatever we want, but I just wanted to show you how this works. So let's press Q. And now all I have to do to rotate these images is just rotate this smaller frame. So what I will do now is say CV2 dot and then rotate. I will pass my smaller frame as the image I want to rotate. And then I will say CV2 dot and then rotate. And we'll go 90 degrees counterclockwise. And I'll copy this and I'll paste this down here. And we'll change this now to be rotate 90 degrees clockwise. And then we will do one more down here. and we'll say rotate. And let's see what other ones I have here for rotate. We'll go rotate 180. Okay, we'll do that. And then this last one, we'll actually just leave in the correct orientation. So let's see what this is going to give us. Let me again deactivate my webcam here. Let's rerun this and let's see what we get. All right, so I've actually ran into a fairly instructive error here. So I'm getting this error saying could not broadcast input array from shape 320-243 into shape 240-323. Now, when you see an error like this, what this means is that the shape of your image is incorrect. So since I'm trying to paste an image of a specific dimensions into a specific area, when I rotate that image, the width and the height of that image change, right? I'm now swapping the width and the height. So when I rotated this image 90 degrees counterclockwise, my width and my height swapped, which now means the 320 that I had for my height now gets changed to 240, right? Or other way around, the 240 I had now gets changed to 320. So it's saying that I cannot broadcast this input array, the input array I'm trying to paste into part of my image, into the correct shape, because it's not the correct shape. So what that tells me is that I can't actually do this rotation that I wanted to, at least not in an image of this size. So what I'm gonna have to do is change this so that rather than rotating 90 degrees, I'm just gonna have to rotate 180. Because if I rotate 180, it's not going to change the width and the height. So let's just rotate two of these 180 and we'll just leave the other ones the same and just see how this looks. So anyways, let me deactivate my webcam. Notice again, all I did here is change this. So I'm no longer rotating 90 degrees. Now I'm rotating 180 degrees. So let's run this and let's see if this works. All right, so now you can see that I'm upside down in these top images. I am the correct direction in the other images. And well, that's what I wanted to show you for this tutorial series. That's all I wanted to cover. There's a few more things related to cameras that we could go through, but they're not entirely important. And this should hopefully give you enough to be able to load up your webcam, you know, manipulate some images, display an interesting image on the screen. And in the next video in this series, I'm going to show you how we can draw stuff onto the screen. So we'll actually draw some rectangles, we'll draw some text, and again, just keep manipulating images and videos. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in another YouTube video.